Hola, bienvenido a mi canal. Hoy estoy hablando sobre cómo he aprendido español siendo un nativo inglés. No soy fluido, pero ahora puedo hablar con cualquier persona. Nos han mentido en la forma de aprender español en la escuela. Tomé 2 años en español en la escuela y no aprendí una chingada. Pero he estado aprendiendo por casi 8 meses y siento que yo sé español mucho más que aprendí en la escuela, porque en la escuela es mierda. My method is optimized for efficiency and actually being able to speak the language. I'll be modeling my journey with a graph known as a bipolar learning curve. It's called this because during the beginning, you'll feel extreme highs because you're learning and seeing tons of progress. But this eventually falls, stagnates, and leads to self-doubt and hopelessness. Okay, I'm joking, but not really. It models the process of learning a new skill. This graph charts your level of confidence slash fluency against time. It gives you insight into how you're gonna feel when you're learning a new skill. The beginning involves a period of accelerated learning, which brings a great deal of satisfaction. But then you get to the middle part where this feeling stagnates and depreciates. You're still learning during this period, but it's not gonna feel like it. Which is where a concept I'm gonna talk about later is actually super important. In addition, during this whole journey, we wanna take advantage of the 80-20 rule, which optimizes for efficiency.
Okay, let's break down the approach. First, define your goal. For me, it's to be conversationally fluent in Spanish. Second, decide the amount of daily learning time. Again, for me, a minimum of 1 hour per day. Now let's talk about how to optimize learning. Learning or skill acquisition causes neuroplasticity, the brain changes associated with learning. So to optimize learning, we should prepare our brains for neuroplasticity. Let's hear a few words from Dr. Andrew Huberman about neuroplasticity.
Most everybody struggles to try and get themselves in action. I mean, we know that actions are the key to neuroplasticity. The strongest drive for adult neuroplasticity is focus. The portal to changing the brain is these high urgency, high attentional states followed by rest, and just keep going, toggling back and forth and back and forth. You break down learning events into kind of smaller, more focused events. The brain can change as an adult at essentially any age. To get better at anything, you gotta get your reps in, whatever that is.
So the key to optimizing learning is to study while in a state of high urgency and focus, followed by states of rest. In addition, I broke down the minimum 1 hour of practice into 2 30-minute sessions. But it's your choice on whether to adopt these practices. Now let's get into my journey.
These are the resources that I used for the first month. So the book I started with was Madrigal's Magic Key to Spanish, and I actually recommend incorporating the Language Transfer podcast as well. Both of these resources take advantage of your base level of English to learn a ton of Spanish. The reason why this is possible is Spanish and English are both Romance languages. These are modern languages that evolved from Vulgar Latin between the 3rd and 8th centuries. Languages like French, Italian, Portuguese, and Spanish all have many words in common with English. For example, you can take advantage of something called language cognates. Cognates are your true friends of words you recognize from your native language that mean the same thing in another language. For example, English words that end in OR are the same in Spanish, minus the pronunciation of the word. And the same thing goes for words that end in AL. While digesting the book, I made sure to record relevant rules, language cognates, and other vocabulary and information that I thought was valuable into my Anki deck. In addition, I created a different Anki deck for the most common 100 words in Spanish. Anki is extremely useful because it basically guarantees that you put this new information into your long-term memory. And the reason why we're focusing on concepts like language cognates and the most common words is because we're taking full advantage of the 80-20 rule, as these words and rules are going to be seen super frequently. Another thing I recommend during this step is to begin passively listening to Spanish. This could be in the form of podcasts or YouTube videos, anything that works for you.
Moving on to how I tackled months 2 to 5.
This is the time where you want to begin conversational practice. So after a month or so of daily practice, you should be able to now manage a basic conversation. See, at this point, you can start actually talking to people. If your main goal is actually being able to speak Spanish, I recommend adding in a conversational type of practice immediately. The internet allows us to do this for free. I joined a Discord group where we had people learning English if they were Spanish speakers, or learning Spanish if they were native English speakers. So there was a beautiful combination of people who are either in the same situation as you, as well as people who are fluent who could provide valuable feedback and practice with you. This is the time where you're going to want to start diving into the media of your choice. At this point, you'll be able to somewhat digest media like podcasts, YouTube videos, songs. Even if it seems like you don't understand what's going on, this is the time where you need to get comfortable with the language. And trust me, it gets easier with time. The last thing I recommend doing during the month 2 to 5 period is finding a bigger list of the most common Spanish words. For me, I found a list of the most common 1,000 words, and I started memorizing them with Anki. I wrote down all the words in that list that I didn't know and started slowly inputting them into my Anki deck, about 10 words per day. And I made sure to include contextually related sentences so that these words actually made sense when I came to use them in my own life. I found a perfect website called Reverso Contexto, and basically on there you can search up any word that you need to know the definition of. And it gives you pretty good contextually related sentences for that word. An important thing about the month 2 to 5 period is mentally, this is the time period where it's the easiest to slack off because there's not as much motivation. Two of the biggest keys for staying interested and actually learning the language is, number one, to incorporate it into your daily life. Meaning you could change the language setting on your phone or do some Pinterest shit and start labeling different stuff in your house as the Spanish word. And number two is to do things that you already enjoy, but do them in your target language. So personally, I like talking to other people. So that Discord server was perfect for me because we could just hop in a voice chat and I could speak with people who are literally from different Spanish speaking countries and practice my Spanish with them and genuinely make connections with them. Like, I'm actually friends with a ton of them now. And so it's super cool because I get to like actually learn colloquial sayings and get to learn about their countries and how their quarantines are going and stuff. So in addition, I personally like stand-up comedy and podcasts. So it was perfect because one of my favorite comedians, Tom Segura, actually started a podcast in Spanish. So I've been watching that and that's been pretty hilarious. And now I have new stand-up comedians to watch. It is a bit harder in Spanish sometimes to understand the jokes, but I mean, it's something that I enjoy to do and that keeps my motivation up and it feels like fun. So that's one of the biggest things when it comes to learning. Through his podcast, I discovered other hilarious Spanish comedians like Franco Escamilla, and I would watch his specials on Netflix, and I would use the Google Chrome extension as well so that subtitles would show up in both languages, English and Spanish, and I could hover over the Spanish word to see the exact English translation. So that was truly a game changer. Like, we live in a time where technology is really on our side. So it's just up to you to make the time in your day to learn, honestly.
Finally, month 6 to 8.
At this point, I felt pretty confident and comfortable with Spanish. I mean, I wasn't perfect, but I could speak with native people and I could actually understand them at their full conversational speed. And at the rest of this point, in terms of like formal practice, like books or those flashcards, I only did my Anki flashcards. And the rest of my practice included fun activities like talking with friends on Discord or watching YouTube or Netflix. Tip number one is consistency is king. So I would make sure not to skip a day for my Anki deck, and I would always make sure to practice for at least 1 hour per day. And I totally get the struggle because there would be so many times where I would feel discouraged. I would feel my speaking ability wasn't improving. And it would be hard to practice, but really setting that rule and setting that habit, it's amazing what time will do. Tip number two is use yourself as a proxy. For example, if there's a word or phrase you consistently hear, but you've realized that you don't know it, that's the perfect indicator that, hey, that's something that you need to learn or you need to go deeper on. So tip number three is to start thinking in Spanish. There'll come a time where you'll be able to start thinking in Spanish, actually start formulating thoughts and sentences in Spanish. As weird as it may look, embrace that ability to start narrating your life through Spanish. It's one of the best forms of practice, in my opinion. Tip number four is don't get comfortable. One of the pitfalls for me was using the same words and phrases and not diversifying my vocabulary. You want to break out of this habit. If you find yourself continually using the same words to speak, then try your best to stop using those words or at least try and find alternate ways to say what you want to say. If you find yourself continuously using the same exact words, try this exercise. Think of three different ways to say the same thing or three different ways to use a word that you just learned. It's going to reduce the monotony in the way you speak and give you a ton more confidence when you're actually speaking with people. And the last tip isn't so much a tip, but it's a reminder that you're gonna have a lot of doubt and a lot of fear through this process. Like, there will be 10 times the amount of fear and doubt than you think you would experience when going through a process like this. Like, I personally can't even describe the amount of times I doubted my own ability, or maybe I took a 2-day break and then thought that I lost it all. So just make sure to persevere through this process and know that's part of it. All right, y'all, that's it for this video. Hit that like and subscribe button. If you guys use my method, I'm super interested to hear your guys' stories. So go ahead and comment down below how long it took you to reach your Spanish goals. If you guys want to get exclusive content, join my Patreon. Link for that and link for all the resources I mentioned in the video are going to be in the description down below. See you guys in the next one. Peace.